highlighting a really nice weekend, at least for the first half of it. 62 degrees areas inland, I think, for well away from that lakefront. Let's talk rain chances, though. This is the most important part. As you can see, nothing to worry about today. Today, we tap out on those mid and upper 40s. Going into tomorrow, we start to get in on these rain chances, I would say, by about midday. Temperatures will be in the 40s both days, 50s away from the lake, like you just saw. And then going into Monday, those rain chances start to drop, which could coincide perfectly with the eclipse. I'm really banking on that potential of us getting some breaks in the clouds. I do want to show you some of the river levels because we still have a couple of flood warnings that are in effect. And I want to show you that the Fox River and the Root River are now all going down. And you can see the one near New Munster is still in a minor flood stage. It will be continuing to drop as we go through time. So today, 46 degrees, beautiful, sunny day. Today is your pick day. Tomorrow, then I'm tracking those afternoon showers, and those showers are going to be mainly impacting your second half of the day. Temperatures topping out right around 48 degrees. It's an impact day. And once we get to Monday, we'll be near 60. So we are warming up. We will see a pattern change, but Monday, these showers start to kind of work their way in, mainly in the morning. By the afternoon, they really start to leave. So let me show you Futurecast that picks this up. So today, we're good. There is nothing going on today. You are good to go. The wind is going to be off the lake, so it will be cooler lakeside. So if you are on the lake today, this morning, maybe going for a run, a walk with the dog, just expect it to be a few degrees cooler. And then by Sunday, we see those clouds starting to pick up. You can see that batch of rain right here. 9 o'clock in the morning, we're still in the clear. That rain builds in by about midday or so. And then we just have some scattered showers, maybe a tiny thunderstorm or a little crack of lightning. But I do not expect severe weather. That stays down to the south. That's going to keep moving its way to the north. We get little tiny isolated showers overnight leading into Monday. And Monday does feature a few of those scattered showers as well. But a lot of them move north, and it does look like we could get a break. So over the next couple of days, I think we could at most get another inch of rain, but it's over a long period of time where I do not anticipate any additional flooding. Here's that total solar eclipse. And right there, you see this? Right around the time that we peak, which is 2:08 p.m., look at that. There's a little glimmer of hope that we could have some clear skies, enough for us to see that eclipse. So really banking on that here, hoping that that is holding true. A lot of the areas in totality are going to be socked in the clouds. So if you are traveling for the eclipse, really keep an eye on that forecast, because I'd hate for you to drive super far for it to be impeded by clouds. No